どうしました?
A couple of days ago, we ran a poll asking you guys who you thought would win in a DPS showcase between free-to-play Thoth and Artemis. Out of 1,300 votes, 71% chose Thoth, while the remaining 29% placed their bets on the Violin Girl. In today's video, we will be running four tests. A solo test. A test using a generic free-to-play team comp. The same test with their premium teammates. And finally, a practical test in Hazard Zone Floor 26. I'll be back with some closing remarks, but for now, enjoy.
さっぱり終わらせましょう。やっぱりあなたはいつも正しいみたいです。ここは任せてちょうだい。酔いしれなさい。カロツキ師団のコピーいいリズムね。舞台にしては少し派手に、私の目に狂いはなかったよね。皆さん、落ち着いてきっちり決めちゃいましょう。バッチリ期待に応えてみせます。外しません。最終章の幕開けです。はっ、おりゃ、ほらほら、
あら、無前歩じゃん。戦いに集中して。
はい、
忍法、影縫い。
無前歩じゃん。
戦いに集中して。
はい、
忍法影縫い。
逃げたらね。
最終章の幕開けです。バッチリ期待に応えてみせます。ほらほら、そうね、綺麗さっぱり終わらせましょう。あなたはいつも正しいみたいです。 決めちゃいましょう。すっごい好奇
心だったわ。
残念でした。バッチリ期待に応えてみせます。
You want to know what happened, right? Well, it's pretty simple. This is free-to-play Thoth versus free-to-play Artemis. Let's take a look at Thoth's functor, Pharaoh User Calf. When combat resources are expended, increase skill damage for 2 seconds. For every 1% of the highest combat resource expended, increases skill damage by 0.40%. As you guys can see, when Thoth expands resources, she only expend 1 energy per second. Meaning this functor is literally dead on her. On the other hand, if we look at Violin Girl's Herald Hydra, all she has to do is be in a time fracture to benefit from the functor's bonus. That's the biggest reason she lost here. If you guys have questions, feel free to ask. And as always, until we meet again, friends.
Thank you.
アルテミス、いつでも行けるわ。
時間の無駄にならなければいいけれど。